Oh, would you like us to play something else?
By the guard?
Thank you.
behalf of the Concord Public Ceremonies and Celebrations Committee, I want to welcome you all here today for the annual remembrance ceremony of Merriam's Corner. On this day, we wish to honor the people and the events that so significantly shaped our lives on this spot 232 years ago. Thank you all for coming. Deacon Francis Stenbrosio will now give the invocation.
Unit commanders, bring your units to an ease.
Let us pray. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, Father of us all, we thank you for this lovely good day to remember a very memorial day. We thank you for the gift of this committee that works tirelessly, unselfishly, and diligently to make these days of remembrance possible. We thank very much, and especially this day, all those who have gone before us, who have brought to life the gift you promise us, dear Father, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. They made it possible by their sacrifice and by their shedding of blood. We bless all those gathered here and all those who are with us in heart and spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Deacon DeBergio. The Middlesex County Volunteers, under leadership of Director Jim McConniff and Drum Major Miles McConnon, will now play a medley of revolutionary songs called Melville. This summer, the Middlesex County Volunteers will perform at the Edinburgh, Scotland Military Tattoo. This is the first fife and drum corps ever to be invited.
Thank you.
Nancy Nelson, Superintendent of the Minuteman National Park, will now bring greetings to the town.
Thank you. On behalf of everyone at Minuteman National Historical Park, I'd like to bring greetings to the town of Concord, to its citizens, and to its guests, including the Miriam family. And I would like to invite all of you to explore the park this week, especially as we go into Patriots Day, and better understand the events that led to the creation of our nation.
Thank you, Superintendent Nelson. Denny McIntyre, Chairman of the Board of Selectmen, will present the historical account of this day, State Memorial Observance.
We gather to commemorate events occurred at this very spot on the 19th of April, 1775. In a sense, these events were the inevitable outcome of a colony generated 3,000 miles away by men who for 10 years had sought to replenish an exchequer depleted by a complex war which had already extended over two continents. Gradually, the arbitrariness of various taxes had turned the countryside into a nearly united armed citizenry surrounding a garrison of highly trained regular troops stationed in Boston. The free and independence of the government from colonial administration was truly remarkable. Encouraged, though inflamed by such men as James Otis, John Hancock, and Samuel Adams, there were committees of correspondence, stores of munitions, and companies of Minutemen. The sign of the Concord Minutemen had begun in January of 1775 as a result of a town meeting the previous September. Many of this former militia had already served in the French and Indian campaigns. Meanwhile, the neighboring committees of correspondents had been collecting cannonballs, powder, and shot, and were storing them in Concord's armory. The provincial Congress had been meeting in Concord in early April. No wonder the new British commander, General Gage, felt it essential to restore control over the area. On April 11th, he set a spy, John Howe, who, posing as a gunsmith from Maine in need of employment, learned a great deal about the disposition of the war in Congress. There were also other sources of information, including some local residents with strong Tory sympathies. Based on this information, Gage decided to secretly dispatch a column of regular troops on foot to surprise the colonials, capture the stores, and arrest the more militant citizens. But the colonials also had their sympathizers in Boston, who knew of this intention, and we know how Revere, Dawes, and then Prescott spread the alarm. 700 troops embarked for Charlestown at 11 o'clock on the night of the 18th. And within 2 hours, the church bell was pealing the alarm in Concord. By the time the regulars reached Concord after the skirmish, like the debris, many stores had been hidden, and about 400 Minutemen were gathered in the fields above the North Bridge. Men from Concord and towns to the north and west, many of whose families were formerly from Concord. It is not my purpose this afternoon to relate the details of the fight at the North Bridge, but I will remind you that by 9:30 that morning, when it was over, the British troops had been on the march the whole night and through two exchanges of fire, which they had not expected. After the withdrawal from the bridge, they stayed in the center of town while regrouping and treating their wounded, and then they started their retreat back to Boston. Thus, by the time they arrived at this spot, at 12:30, there were reported to be about 1,100 Minutemen in the area. They had come from Acton, Bedford, Billerica, Chelmsford, Concord, Framingham, Harvard, Lexington, Littleton, Reading, Stowe, Wilmington, Woburn, and as far away as Newington, New Hampshire. At that time, this property was owned by Yankton Merriam, a selectman of the town. An ineffectual volley was fired by the grenadiers at the Reading Minutemen. That challenge started a classic guerrilla action, which continued for many hours as the outnumbered British retreated towards Boston. At least two British privates were killed and several others will appear during that initial exchange. By the time the day was over, 49 colonials had died, 73 British troops were killed, plus 173 wounded and missing. Thus began a war that would not end until Yorktown, more than 6 long years later. And thus, our nation was born.
Thank you, Selectman McIntyre. At this time, we'd like to acknowledge the dignitaries in attendance. State Representative Corey Atkins. Caucus Selectman. The Confederate flag. Our Marshal Joe Vendy. Our wreath bearers, Matthew and Michael Merlino. Once again, our honored citizen, Dot Higgins. Deacon D'Ambrosio. 4-H Vice and Drum Corps. Representatives of the Marion family. Caucus Independent Battery, the Caucus Girl Scouts, the Middlesex County Volunteers, the Sons of the American Revolution from Connecticut, the Sons of the American Revolution from Vermont, Westford Minutemen, the Wilmington Minutemen, and any of those who I've missed. Your participation today is greatly appreciated and should inspire all of us to make time in our busy schedules to honor our heritage and pay tribute to those who have gone before us and laid the foundation of our freedom. With the unit commanders, guidons, wreath bearers, please come forward for the decoration of the monument. County volunteers will now play the national anthem, followed by our own Concord Minutemen. Give Davis of Mount Musket, Wally.
Forward! March!